Today's video is sponsored by Elysium Health, which produces Basis, a dietary supplement that's clinically proven to increase NAD, a natural occurring substance in our bodies that declines as we age. This video is made in collaboration with Real Life Lore, a YouTube channel that asks head-scratching questions about things you didn't even know you needed to know. Pop over to RLL after this vid if you're looking for an interesting perspective on today's topic. Can cosmetics reverse age? Humanity has been trying to answer that question forever. One of the oldest medical texts, a papyrus dating all the way back to 2500 BC, contained a recipe for transforming an old man into a youth. It was a face cream of fruit and mud. Huh, not too different from some of today's cosmetic products. Alchemists, medieval predecessors to modern-day chemists, attempted to create the elixir of life, a mysterious substance that was fabled to keep you young forever. In the 1800s, the father of endocrinology, scientist Charles Brown Sicard, even got into the act by injecting himself with a mash of dog and guinea pig testicles as soon as he felt old age looming over him. Shocker! None of these things made anyone any younger. Anyone could claim anything. Consumers were disgruntled. Mass chaos ensued. That was until 1938, when a law descended from the mountaintops of DC that said henceforth, cosmetics shall only beautify, cleanse, and promote attractiveness. Well, in reality, it was actually a little more toned down than that. According to the definition, cosmetics can only hide a wrinkle, not actually remove it. Oh, did you want more than that? Well, now you're talking about a drug, and that requires proof of safety and effectiveness before it reaches store shelves. Okay, but wait. If I stand in front of the wall of cosmetics in the beauty aisle, I see a different story. Marketing claims like regenerates cells, repairs wrinkles, and heals skin seems to suggest that reversing age is possible, even if only on a minute scale. So, cosmetics can reverse aging? What if I told you there might be a gray area between cosmetics and drugs? Welcome to the world of COSMECEUTICALS, a marketing term coined in the 80s by a notable dermatologist who pointed out some cosmetics could have a real effect on the structure or the function of the skin, or at least used ingredients that could. Heard of retinol or vitamin C, anyone? However, since COSMECEUTICALS are a category that isn't recognized by the FDA, these cosmetics with their supposed drug-like capabilities don't undergo the same scrutiny as pharmaceuticals. No one has to state the percentages or the active ingredients, or even provide clinical proof that they're actually having an effect. That sounds kind of sketchy. Are the ingredients in the cosmetics stable? Can they penetrate the skin barrier? Who knows? They may work and they may not. We'll never know unless someone starts doing studies that allows us to figure what benefits are real and which products deliver them. The supplement market has the same problem. A pair of studies done only a few years ago show that many supplements didn't even contain the ingredients they claim to use. Yeah, your supplement pill might as well be packed with sawdust. That's a problem that Elysium, makers of the supplement Basis, is trying to tackle. Despite the lack of regulation requiring them to do so, Elysium has done human trials with Basis. The trials show that when users take the recommended dose of the supplement, there is a 40% increase in the amount of NAD, otherwise known as nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. NAD works with sirtuins, a family of proteins connected to longevity in animals. But sirtuins don't work alone. They only function when NAD is present. NAD functions as a helper molecule, aiding sirtuins in DNA maintenance and mitochondrial function. Think of sirtuins as a car, getting you from place to place. NAD is like the gas. Without it, driving anywhere would be impossible. Without NAD, sirtuins can't function. As we age, our NAD levels go down, and scientists think the decrease may cause our cells to work less efficiently over time. In theory, increasing NAD may support how we age and improve our health span, the number of years we live in our optimal health. Elysium's co-founder, Dr. Garante, the director of the Glenn Lab for the Biology of Aging at MIT, says, "We're not trying to extend lifespan, we want to improve health span." So we know NAD is having an effect on the body, and because Elysium released Basis as a supplement, we get to try it for ourselves now, instead of waiting decades. After all, those of us concerned about aging aren't getting any younger. Now let's see what my friend Joseph from Real Life Lore has to say about the topic. Click here to see his latest video, and here to check out his channel. And if you want to find out more about what mouthwash has to do with gonorrhea, or what a fake tan and a steak have in common, you may want to check out these videos.